and spiritually.
Earth is part flat of who we are,
which is why settling, staying stuck in a rut, treading the lukewarm water of mediocrity, or worse, is so excruciating. All of Mother Nature's creatures are designed to fully flourish before they drop dead. You, just like all living things, are meant to take up space on this planet. Shrinking back and denying yourself the things that bring you great joy, living under a cloud of guilt, refusing to make an impact, ain't why you're here. The Earth is not here for us to pillage, but it is here for us to enjoy, care for, and appreciate. You living your fullest life and making all the money required to do so doesn't take anything away from anyone else, any more than you refusing a ham sandwich because someone somewhere is starving helps them. Greed comes from the same black mindset as poverty. Staying broke because you fear it's worse to be rich, or that you don't deserve money, or that you getting rich somehow prohibits someone else from getting rich too, is all rooted in lack. Lack is the state of being you're in when you believe you're in need of, when you believe that what you desire doesn't exist, when your outlook on life is glass with a hole in the bottom, as opposed to a glass half full. A lack mindset believes that there's not enough to go around, that you're not good enough, worthy enough to flourish, that the money you spend may never make its way back to you, etc. Digging out on money and things and experiences is also based in fear and lack. Fear of never having enough, fear of not being secure, fear of being unlovable, trying to fill a bottomless hole in your heart. Nothing in excess is healthy. Gluttony is just as devastating as it is anorexia. You denying yourself your heart's desires is not noble. It's a waste of some damn good desires. And it denies the world our only opportunity to bask in more of you. If you sometimes feel hopeless because of all the pain and suffering in the world, and worry, who the hell am I to get rich when others are starving and being bombed out of their countries and enslaved? Know this.
No.
One of the best things you can do is get rich. Because of the way our world is structured, money and power are intertwined. So if you want to help make a positive change, money is one of the most effective tools you can use to do it. Yes, you can donate your time, organize, protest, lobby, alert the masses, post incensed rants on Facebook, but you will be much more effective if you have the energy, options, and freedom that come with not being in financial struggle. Not to mention the resources to spend however you see fit. Instead of complaining and freaking out about the power-mongering, greed-obsessed fatheads who are perpetrating such harm on the planet and handing them even more power by staying broke because you don't want to be like them, why not focus yourself on getting rich instead so you can make a big difference? You can do some really cool stuff with money. Don't let the jerks who give it a bad name ruin it for you. You cannot give what you do not have. So if you want to help others, you have to take care of yourself first. This is why they always tell you on airplanes that you have to put your oxygen mask on first before you help someone else with theirs. They have to remind us of this because it's counterintuitive. Unless you are a sociopath, it's your nature to help. Few things light up the human heart like helping and bringing joy to others. Trust in the fact that when you're well taken care of financially, you'll be even more poised and inspired to spread the love. Our world, now more than ever, needs as many compassionate, creative, big-hearted, conscious people to be as rich as possible so we can turn this mother around. I mean, imagine if you and all the people you love and respect had assloads of money, and if they felt grateful and empowered by it, not icky and guilty, and if they could afford to spend it on themselves and others and on saving our planet in ways that uplifted everyone involved. Please take a moment to really envision the specifics of this as it pertains to yourself and the spectacular people in your life. Take them all one by one and imagine how they